EA Sports coverage of the NFL takes us to the Carolinas and Bank of America Stadium here in Uptown Charlotte. Alongside my broadcast partner, Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gaudin. And as we look at this matchup, every time there's something different to focus on. So I'll just ask you, what do you see here in this one?
Well, Rembrandt, you've given me a pretty blank canvas to focus on, haven't you?
Yeah.
Where do you think I'm going to go with this?
Secondary?
You know me. You know me well, right? In a game like this, it's always about the secondary. Can they handle the passing attack and make a few plays?
Here's the punter, Bradley Pinion, on to get us started. And off we go from Uptown Charlotte. And he takes this near the 25, just a little pass there, call it the 26. And now it looks like he's in some discomfort after being tackled at the end of that return. So as the medical staff takes a look, we'll step aside. First down, they'll start out with Hubbard, and he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up.
Nice chunk of yards on first down. It really opens up your options for what you want to do on second. You go right back to him and hope he explodes, or sucker the defense in before throwing over the top.
Second and six, just inside the 30. Miles Sanders, first carry of the game. Fast footwork by Sanders, and they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. Give him 15 there, and the Panthers have a first down.
We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles, and his feet never stop moving?
And they'll send the tight end in motion. To throw here, Dalton. He'll find the former Steeler, Deontay Johnson. And he's brought down. Back-to-back nice gains, that one for 14 yards and another first.
Now that was pretty. They executed that curl route versus zone coverage, and that changes things a little bit because against man, it's often a tight curl, tight, sharply run route. Against zone, you're just looking for that open spot, that dead area, so you may curl it a little bit wider just to get to that place.
And usually a tight window. He fired a bullet in there for the completion. And they'll run on first down with Hubbard, and he's going to be swallowed up as he got forward for maybe a yard, and it's second down. Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
Now Dalton. Completing it to the right side, Johnson. And that's going to be good for another first down as the tackle's made at the Falcons' 29-yard line. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks. Well, that early game script that they drew up is working pretty well here on this first drive. Already in field goal range, Charles, knocking on the door of the red zone.
You know, Brandon, when we met with the coaching staff, they kind of predicted that they would come out firing like this. I think you and I were a little skeptical it'd be this easy, but they certainly knew what they were doing in scouting, in preparation, and understanding what their team was capable of.
Looked like he was trying to bounce it outside, but no success.
Yeah, sometimes you got to just figure out where you're going to go, and sometimes you just have to take it to another spot. In trying to get it outside, the defensive pursuit was there and just ran him down.
So Dalton now. A short throw hauled in by Trimble. And down inside the 15 he goes. The catch and run there, good for 16 and a first.
But when you hit him on the move like that, and he's able to get into open field with a full head of steam, oh boy, it's going to be tough to get him down.
Yeah, there was a big window. They're lucky they did get him down. From the 13 now, they work on first and 10. They'll run with Sanders up the middle. And he'll be taken down here at about the 11. Jesse Bates made the tackle from his safety spot.
Watching that play unfold and watching him complete it brought back memories of doing all those pursuit drills to make sure you don't over-pursue and let a guy get a cutback lane on you. He did that very well.
You praised him on tape yesterday for the angles that he takes to the ball. Took a great angle right there.
And Dalton to throw. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. That'll go for a gain of 7, and that's going to bring up 3rd and 2.
Well, safe to say the passing game has found a rhythm. He's now 4 of 4, but might need to be 5 of 5 to keep this drive going here as they face a 3rd down.
And maybe perhaps you show a running play, right? Maybe a little play action here to go ahead and let him throw the ball downfield. I wouldn't get away from him flinging it because...
Now he's hit, and Dalton lost the football, and the Falcons grab it.
Well, give some credit to the defense. They forced the big play, knocked the ball free from him, but... It's a cardinal sin by the quarterback. Know where you are on the field, and he just gave up at a minimum 3 points.
Instead of getting down, takes the contact. The turnover ensues.
So the Falcons make their way out behind their new quarterback for 2024, signed back in March, the veteran Kirk Cousins.
And coming off of an offseason where Kirk Cousins was coming back from an Achilles injury, he thought that was going to be his biggest challenge. Instead, the Falcons drafted Michael Penix out of Washington in the 1st round. And while that was a jolt, Kirk Cousins has a great ability to just shake things off, move forward, and let his talents come through.
In motion, the tight end. Cousins now after the fumble recovery. Pressure comes in. He's brought down. It's a Panther sack. That one will set him back nearly 10 yards here on 1st down on the sack.
It may be cliche, but it is something that holds up over time, doesn't it? If you're the visitors, you don't want to let the crowd in the game early.
Yeah, and that's exactly what they did there. But you said also this defense, they're going to give them a lot of looks like we just saw there, aren't they?
They certainly are. They're a proud unit, and they're going to ride the momentum of this crowd with them, and that's why they got after them early.
And they need to work to at least get some of this yardage back after the sack. 2nd and 19. Open man is Kyle Pitts, his tight end. And he is out of bounds, able to get it across the 20-yard line. They get 14 back, but it leads now to a 3rd down.
And that was yardage that they needed there after the sack on 1st down. They didn't get all of it back, but now they look at 3rd down as a manageable situation, one that they have a much better chance of picking up.
From the shotgun, it's Cousins. Throw out wide is incomplete.
And 3rd down is a key down in any game you play. And 3rd down defense, something we've got to watch in this one. Got to be effective on the passing downs. That's a pretty good first step right there.
On 4th down, Bradley Pinion on to punt for the Falcons.
Fair catch signaled for and taken just shy of the 30-yard line. So a change of possession here on the punt. And the Panthers will take over now, 1st and 10. Andy Dalton. That's complete out right to the tight end, Trimble. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. He got 29 yards that time.
And that was good protection there. No, that was great protection there because it allowed him to lock in on his receiver, although I think he was looking for his tight end on the corner route all the way. Nice connection there for a really nice gain.
From Falcon territory now, here's 1st and 10 at the 43. Dalton now to pass. He gets it left side to Johnson. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. A good-looking drive so far for the Panthers and a first down here.
To win any route, you've got to break down the defender, and that's exactly what happened here on this really nicely executed curl route.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Here's Dalton. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
They're bringing a lot of pressure here already in the first quarter. Already sacked him once. Now they get in there and knock another one away. You think maybe that tuck rule being gone makes defenses a lot bolder?
Yes, indeed. That time, lucky that the arm was going forward. Incomplete pass.
Throwing, Dalton. And he's going to be taken down. Pressure gets there back at the 39-yard line. Marching in for the sack, Matthew Judon.
Was certainly not an ideal first quarter for him. Remember, he lost the fumble earlier, and here he ends up on the ground with a sack.
And sometimes what happens when you make a mistake early, you get too cautious going forward. Just cover up the football and take care of it and be able to cut it loose. Otherwise, your offense is going to stall.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Under pressure again, and down he goes again. Give the sack to Lorenzo Carter. And that is the third sack this offensive line has allowed this first quarter.
Yeah, that puts him on pace. Let me do the rudimentary math here. To be sacked 12 times in a game, I know he's not going to go for that. I wonder if it's going to reshape what they decide to do on offense in terms of play calling.
Well, I can tell you what, when he popped up, shaking his head, frustrated right now behind center. Carolina punt team out there led by Johnny Hecker. Back deep, Ray McLeod.
And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. The crowd may be losing just a little bit of the edge after back-to-back punts.
They want some big plays. They want to see some offense. They want to see somebody break away, whether it's through the air or on the ground. Now it'll be interesting to see where the patience is on both sides. Each head coach, can you hang in there and not try and force something that could put your team in some jeopardy?
No score after one on EA Sports. Second quarter now, Falcon football, as they've got it with a first and 10. A run for the first time with Bijan Robinson. And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30. That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down.
Well, how about the big guy there showing some agility? He just float from his D-tackle position in order to make that play.
So their task a little bit more difficult now. Second and 13 that they're walking up on. Cousins now. Over the middle, that's caught by McLeod. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. It's his first catch, and it'll be good for 15 at a first down.
Of course, the catch was nice, but how about what happened after? Able to stay on his feet and gain all that additional yardage. So many of these slot guys, I think, have running back in their background.
And they'll send the tight end in motion here. Cousins. And complete to Drake London. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. So the completion good for 6 yards, and it's second down. Cousins to throw it. And able to complete this one to McLeod. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down. come flying in. One of the Falcons moved early.
That flag accepted, and it backs the offense up a little bit.
A false start backs him up 5, first and 15. They'll throw again. Cousins.
A throw left sideline falls incomplete.
No sense risking anything there on first down. Even though he's still in the pocket, he had a receiver out to his side, so just put that in a spot where the only people who could make a play on it are the trainers and the coaches. Well done.
So they'll come up after the incompletion for second down. To throw is Cousins.
That's going to be caught by Pitts.
And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Panthers' 25-yard line. A good pickup there, a 22.
Excellent catch there by Pitts. And there aren't many players in his position who can rival the type of athleticism he brings to the table. Here in year four, the Falcons, they're expecting a monster year from him.
Right back to Pitts again. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. Another catch for him there. This one good for 11. First down. Seems as if the passing attack starting to heat up a little bit here in the second quarter.
You can sense and you can see the momentum because now they're reading their patterns downfield. They're understanding the coverages and they're finding the open holes in the defense.
Complete to Mooney on the slant. And the Falcons are looking at first and goal as he's tackled all the way down at the 2-yard line.
Just picking up yardage in bunches here these last few plays. They have moved right down the field, and just like that, they're going to be set up with a first and goal.
From the 2, here's first and goal.
To throw, Cousins. And that is caught. Touchdown, Falcons.
Bijan Robinson.
A 2-yard touchdown grab.
And the Falcons post the first points of the ball game as they take the lead here in this second quarter.
We see this route all the time, but when it's well executed, it's a beauty.
And it feels like the fade takes forever to develop, like that ball is just hanging in the air.
And the reason why is that the receiver is trying his best to work the defender inside and give himself space to fade away from him and catch the football. And that's exactly what happened there.
No going for 2. They'll kick the point after. It's good, and that gives the Falcons a 7-0 lead. So that one, a pretty time-consuming 10-play drive.
And it was capped off by a touchdown catch from Bijan Robinson.
Following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away.
And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. The Carolina offense about ready to go.
They'll be looking to match that touchdown from a moment ago. 7-0 is the score as they begin with a first down.
Here's Dalton. Got his man. It's Jonathan Mingo.
And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll leave him with a second and just a few inches left.
That was a nicely run slant route. And what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down.
11 yards and a Panther first down.
That's pretty much meat and potatoes right there, wasn't it? Just go right at them and let your big horse charge up the middle. Not too fancy there, was it?
Nothing fancy at all. Challenging that defense, and on that go-around, the offense won the challenge.
From the gun, Dalton looks to throw.
A short throw hauled in by Trimble.
And he is down at the 48. A pickup of four that started at 148-yard line and ended at the other.
The completion was given up, but that's why you play zone defense, so that you can have people around the ball when it's caught and you don't give up much run after the catch.
From the 48-yard line, here's the second down and six. A give up the middle, Hubbard. And he'll get this down only to about the 46. 2 yards the gain there, and now they're left with a third and about four for a first. The completion on first didn't get much, and now the run on second doesn't get a whole lot either.
Well, if you're a good play caller, you've already looked ahead and anticipated this type of situation. Already down on his play sheet, trying to dial up a big third down play.
To throw here, Dalton. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And he is going to have a Panthers first down by about 3 yards or so as they wind up getting seven there on third and four.
And Brandon, from our time in college football, where receivers weren't running the traditional NFL route tree, one thing they did learn, find open areas, find soft spots, and set up and catch the ball. And I think we just saw that there.
Yeah, we saw that indeed, picking up the first.
Down at the 35, it'll be second down.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
2 minutes on the clock, second quarter, 7-0 ball game. From the 35, here's second and six.
Now Dalton.
Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Jesse Bates. And he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Falcon defense has a touchdown.
An excellent play there, CD, on the pick six. And I think they, were they a nickel? Did they have an extra DB out there?
Yeah, Brandon, I think they were in standard nickel, not the Buffalo, as teams like to call it, meaning three safeties for big nickel. They just wanted to take away the quarterback's throwing lanes, and that's exactly what they did and came through with a big-time pick six.
Koo for the extra point.
And it's good to make it 14-0. A heck of a play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air.
And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line.
Here are the Panthers now as their offense comes back out onto the field. And they're in a bind early here, down 14-0. Are you worried at this stage or still too early?
You're worried. You're just trying not to transmit it to the rest of your team. You want to make sure that they stay positive. But at the same time, you're wondering, how are we going to move the football? What do we have on this play sheet that can work? Get back to basics is usually your answer. And make sure you find the guy who can move the ball fastest for you if you just get it in his hands.
Yeah, still second quarter. You get points on the board here. I think you're feeling okay.
And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And they'll be left with a second and about a foot. Dalton. And they're not able to hook up there. Incomplete. Some of the fans here don't seem too happy about what we've seen in this first half.
No, not at all, and I understand why. They look lethargic, out of sync, and it shows on the scoreboard.
An incomplete pass on second down leads us to third and inches. Out of the gun, it's Dalton. A short throw hauled in by Trimble. Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. So on fourth down, here's Johnny Hecker to punt it away. They call that a punt of 38 yards officially. And the Falcons will be taking over first and 10. Atlanta prepped and readied for its next possession. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You could never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
Now Cousins. Into the hands of London. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. A 14-yard gain there as they look to improve this 14-point lead.
Well, this is where reading defenses and practice time comes into play. You've got to know what you're running versus zone versus man and how to run the proper route. And they just executed that one pretty well.
Throwing his Cousins. And this will be caught by Mooney. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. The Falcon passing game looking good on this drive as they get the first down. The Falcons going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Throwing, Cousins. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
He did a fine job there of not hitting him before the ball arrived, and I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
And this throw incomplete. Well, the defender all over him that time, but it's going to lead to third down.
It's another zone defense. It looks like it's open for possibilities, but they did a nice job patrolling the middle of the field and forcing an incompletion.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Cousins again. He's got his target. That's complete. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20. Great way to convert on third down there. 21 yards the play.
Well, things are definitely going right for them here in the first half. Pick a down, any down, even third down, no problem. They get a connection there and pick up a fresh set of downs, continuing to move the ball.
Now Cousins. He's got the hook up to McLeod. And the result here, a pickup of 8, leaves him with 2 to go on second down. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. From the right hash, and this one just a chippy.
Koekkoek knocks this one through the post.
And that will extend their lead even further.
So a capper there to a pretty good first half.
And I love the way that they put a chokehold on the clock and pretty much drained everything before they put the field goal on the board as they headed into the half.
So barring a touchback, this likely the final act of the half as the kick is away. Now Raheem Blackshear going to take this one out.
The lane opens here. He's past the 30. So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far.
As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
This was an extremely one-sided first half. One team showed up, ready to go. The other's been in a daze thus far, but there's still plenty of time left for this one to tighten up significantly.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. A very one-sided first half, 17-0 our score as we get going in quarter number three. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27. The Falcons offense ready to get going to begin this third quarter. And Charles, they've got the lead. Put your coaching hat on here now. What's the game plan for the second half?
I think getting the running game going a little bit more, because I thought in the first half, they didn't get it moving the way that they would like. They had success throwing it, but I think these first couple of drives, they'll want to get those running backs going and give them more opportunities, and I will guarantee you that those guys were lobbying for them in the locker room at halftime.
Throw over the middle, going to be caught here by Pitts.
And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll leave him with a second and just a few inches left.
And after that completion, you can understand why so many teams in the league are emphasizing speed on defense at every position. The tight ends have created so many tough matchups now. If you can't run with a tight end as a linebacker, this is going to be the result every time.
Off the play fake, Cousins. That's out wide here for Robinson.
And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there.
A gain of five, good enough for the first down.
Well, that was a pretty favorable situation there. What would you call that, second and manageable? Smart play, too. Didn't force it downfield when he didn't have it. Just checked it down, let him get the first down, and that's exactly what he did.
Cousins now. That's caught by Werner, the tight end.
And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. Call it a gain of six on the play, and it's second down.
Well, it certainly feels like there are more stars at the tight end position than there were even 10 years ago. And I think it's become more of a glamour position because of the ways it can hurt a defense, and guys want to be involved. They can be in line, close to the line of scrimmage. They can split out like receivers. But hands, route running, speed, and some toughness to go across the middle, you put it all together, you got a heck of a tight end candidate.
A big run there, 29 yards and a first. Defense really kept him in check running the football in the first half. Maybe that'll be a spark for him here in half two.
So two words come to mind for me. Resilient, because he has to keep bouncing back after some limiting runs. And how about relentless? Keep going, knowing that you may pop one as he just did there.
Cousins locates Mooney on the out route
and brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7.
Two catches in the first half. Now he's got a third here, and it's good for a first.
Boy, how about the speed with which this offense can get down the field? It's taking them no time at all to get down here, and now they're set up with a first and goal.
Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit them, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal.
That's good for a gain of 6, second and goal.
Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
Second and goal from the 1. Robinson. And a nice move will yield nothing as he stopped behind the line. The tally there, minus 2 yards, brings up 3rd down.
That's a really alert defense there because they saw the heavy look come in from the offense, countered it with extra linebackers who brought a little bit of speed and heft, and able to really make a big-time play for their defense.
3rd and goal for Cousins. And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Ray McCloud, a 2-yard touchdown grab.
And the Falcons take the opening kickoff of the 3rd quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead. So another touchdown there, and even though we're still just here in the 3rd quarter, kind of hard now to see them giving up this lead.
And this is just an offense that's imposing its will right now. You name it, they're able to do it. If you're the play caller, whatever you want to select is there. You want to run it, you want to throw it, pick a play, any play. They're rocking and rolling right now.
Ku able to connect on the extra point, and the lead is now 24. So that drive takes him down the field in 8 plays. And the Falcons score to cap it off. Now Pinion with the kickoff honors following the touchdown. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. The Panthers' offense and their quarterback ready to go once more. And it's been a struggle for him all afternoon. This defense has really done a nice job of making him earn everything he gets, and it's prevented him from getting into any kind of rhythm here today. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And their halftime hole now even deeper. They need a big drive here just to answer the first touchdown of the second half scored against them.
They were down at the half. Now, as you mentioned, they're down a little bit bigger. But no time for discouragement. Just got to get back to it, right? Put your shoulder against the boulder and start pushing and try and get back to where you were to start the half.
Here's 2nd and 7.
They'll bring the tight end in motion right. On the counter, this is Hubbard. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 13 yards, 1st down, Panthers.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
Only able to gain a couple there, and that's going to bring up 2nd down.
Caught that look from you there, partner. I think we're on the same page on that one. Just his first catch, I think we both thought he'd be a little more active in the passing game. Let's see if that's the start of them trying to get the ball to him a little bit more here in the second half.
And Dalton to throw. Pressure brought in, and the Falcons get there for the sack.
That time, multiple defenders getting pressure, And it's a loss of six.
You can just see it in their body language. They're starting to see victory on the horizon now. And if it comes to fruition, they got to give a game ball to the front seven. Defensive line has taken charge and controlled this game. Face the challenge of stopping this opposing offense, and they've done so with ease.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. In motion goes the tight end. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. That's caught by Mingo, right side. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. So the completion results there in 9 yards. And that'll bring up fourth down.
But it appears that they read man defense and went to the out route. And what you have to do on that one is the receiver's got to make sure he works the defender towards the middle of the field to give himself space to cut to the outside and have that ball delivered with good timing. And they got it done.
Here's McLeod on the return. It's a 39-yard punt, 8 on the return. And it will be Falcon football. The Falcons offense and Kirk Cousins getting ready for this next possession. And we'll take you through some of the highlights here. You'll notice he had a hand in a lot of them so far. He's got this offense rolling right now. The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that in Charles's defense. They were very frustrated after giving up 6 the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways, because you know they're both motivated, they both game plan for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
Cousins. Able to complete this one to McLeod. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. Fifth catch of the afternoon, and that gives him a first down. To throw, Cousins. Short throw caught by Pitts. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. The catch and run, good for 24 yards.
And while we may be looking at the scoreboard, this offense certainly is not, because they're showing no signs of backing down, even with a 3-score lead here in the third quarter. I think they keep taking their shots. They've seen blown leads happen throughout this league. They don't want to fall victim to it themselves.
So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material. Robinson up the middle. And that one opened up for him well, as he'll take this down to the 26-yard line. That's over 40 yards of movement with those last two plays.
Some big plays in the passing game on this drive, and here's one out of the running game. So the passing game loosening things up. Now there's room to roam.
Here's Cousins. And that is going to be incomplete, as he led him a bit too much.
Well, a momentary speed bump there with that throw, partner. The defense had other ideas, and they're trying to mount a small stand before this drive reaches the end zone.
Second and 10 now, third quarter from Charlotte. Straight ahead, it's Robinson. And they're knocking on the door now, as a good run there going to take this to about the 10-yard line. 59 yards rushing for him now, and he's carried the ball just 5 times. Offensive line right now really freeing up the rushing lanes on this drive.
And we have to give them props. They've earned them. But these big runs that we're seeing, they don't result without everyone else being involved as well. Blocking on the perimeter has to take place downfield, too.
Cousins to throw it. This is caught, and he takes this down to about the 2 before going out of bounds. Nice gain of 8 that time, but it's second and goal.
Well, that's what you're looking for when you're wanting to throw the ball downfield. You want one of those guys who can play out on the perimeter, can play out wide, who can not only get open, but when they're covered, can uncover themselves downfield and create catches.
Robinson is not going anywhere. He'll be hit and dropped for no gain at the 2-yard line.
Call it no gain that time, and now it's third and goal.
So a little extra time to ponder this third and goal as we played three quarters. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
And we're back now in Charlotte. A lot of folks starting to make their way to the parking lot. Their guys trail big here to begin quarter number four. They'll look to throw on third and goal. And this is caught for a Falcon touchdown. Kirk Cousins with three touchdown passes now in the afternoon.
And the Falcons have sewn this one up as they add to their lead here in the fourth. So still throwing here in the fourth quarter with a pretty sizable lead, and now that lead even more sizable. And if nothing else here, CD, a chance to pile on some stats before this one wraps up, and he did just that.
Brandon, convention tells us it's time for them to get off the gas a little bit, right? But you and I both know the receivers don't want them to, because as you noted, this is their chance to pile on the stats. If they got their way, they try to get every single spot in the depth chart points before this game is over.
Following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away.
And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line.
Now the Panthers offense, they get set to come back onto the field.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. It's been a tough go for them. It's still without any points here in the fourth quarter and a big deficit, Charles, but they moved the football on some drives. They just haven't had any points.
Yeah, and I know in their minds they're thinking the game plan has actually been working. We just haven't scored points. Well, isn't that the bottom line, partner, to put points on the board? So if you're moving it and you're not scoring, is it really working? Right now they've got nothing left to lose. They might as well go for broke.
Dalton now to pass.
They'll run the screen with Hubbard.
They hold him to only two there on the screen. It's second down.
And that's all about recognition right there, because he's got to go from pass rush mode to pursuit mode, what defensive line coaches like to call retracing. And he's able to retreat and make the tackle for just a short gain.
Second down and 8.
Here's Dalton. Looking for Johnson, and it's intercepted.
And the Falcons are going to have the short field here as they'll take over right at the 50. Well, they've got the huge lead. Now they have another interception on the defensive side. Seems like everything they touch in this one, Charles, turns to gold.
And they have to be awfully happy right there to get what appears to be one more for the road and help seal away one of their best efforts of the season.
Atlanta regains possession of the football. And as we look back at how we got here, you'll notice a common theme in these highlights. A lot of yardage through the air. The passing game has been sharp right from the outset. Good starting field position for them as they come up first and 10 right at the 50-yard line. On the give, here's Robinson.
Pass the 20. Touchdown, Falcons.
Bijan Robinson.
His second touchdown of the afternoon.
And the Falcons add another 6 points to what's going to be a blowout victory.
They seemingly just continue to score at will. And as great as it's been for the offense, you got to feel for that defense down there.
I love how you use the word will, because both teams came into the game with the will to win. But one team has obviously imposed its will on the other and broken them. Because what we're seeing right now, wow, that's a defense that's in tatters after what they faced in this ballgame.
Extra point by Koo, up and good. And this one was over a while ago as they just add on to that big lead. Now Pinion with the kickoff honors following the touchdown. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29. Now the offense for the Panthers here, getting the football back.
And let's face it, this drive is not going to have any bearing on this game, but it's kind of important for one reason, isn't it?
It certainly is. You got to get points. And okay, all right, I'm being facetious here. But you get points, you feel a little bit better about yourself as you move on to the next one.
Dalton and the Panthers now with a first and 10, just shy of the 30.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive.
That one complete to Leggett.
And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game, because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
To throw here, Dalton. And the Falcons get there. The Falcons get the sack. Down he goes.
David Onyemata able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon.
But when this game is done, the credit will go to the consistent pressure on the quarterback as a huge cause of this win. Most teams are happy if they get a few of these games per year. You know they're going to watch this tape over and over, try to identify what's working and keep it going.
The Panthers on third down, just 1 for 5 to this point. This is 3rd and 8.
Andy Dalton. Ball had his hands on it, couldn't bring it in. Pretty symptomatic of how this game's been going.
And that's another play that's painted the picture of this game overall. It's been a blowout. It's been continually fueled by big turnovers and stops for one side and an inability to advance the ball from the other.
Here's Johnny Hecker now, as he'll punt it away for the 4th time today.
And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
The Falcons offense and their quarterback headed out for this next possession. And you get a look at the numbers, so they don't even tell the whole story. This has been a tremendous performance to this point.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line.
Well, they don't really need the points here, Charles, given what we're looking at on the scoreboard, but they've scored on 3 consecutive possessions, 3 consecutive drives, and I'm sure that they would like to keep that streak going here and continuing to pour it on.
And things have gotten that way in the NFL, haven't they, partner? Because in the old days, people would, you know, they'd get off the gas a little bit, right? But now, people continue to accelerate. But we'll see what they decide to do as they come out for this one. But the way that this game has gone, they've got to be awfully happy with their execution overall.
On second down, another shot for Robinson.
And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield.
134 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he's the guy they've turned to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it to him and keep picking up good yardage.
On first and 10, it's Robinson. And a good job of finding the open space to run as he's down close to the 30 here.
Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again.
No doubt those are the types of carries they're looking for here, Charles. The lead in the fourth quarter, this is when coaches that have a reliable running game, they breathe a little easier on the sideline.
Yeah, they love the idea that they can take the air out of the football at this point of the game. That means they're really counting on that offensive line, counting on the runners, taking care of the football. Because you're going to tell your quarterback, hey, no time to be a hero. We're not going to throw it here. Just eat up that clock. And if you have the ball, they can't score.
Brendan, every great running backs coach that I've talked with has always talked about when you have great vision, you're not consciously thinking about your cuts and your moves. You're just doing them. And I think that's what we're seeing tonight. He's about run them into submission, hasn't he?
You took the words right out of my mouth. I was just going to use that phrase. He has run them into submission.
Wave the white flag.
That's good for a gain of 6, second and goal.
I think a lot of people ask the same question all the time. Why do we see so many slants in the red zone? Well, the windows are tighter. Everything's more condensed. It has to be quicker, and you've got to deliver the ball on time. Your biggest worry? Ball gets tipped in the air, because if that happens, then it's fair game for the defense.
To the back of the end zone, but too high. Over everybody and incomplete.
Well, their passing attack, even though that one was incomplete, has been really sharp in this one. It's resulted in a lot of touchdowns, and it looks like they're not going to stop throwing the football until the very end of this one.
Well, that will certainly make everyone involved on offense pretty happy, because that gives them all a chance to pad their stats a bit. But as far as the actual need, you and I both know they can just run this clock out, because this one, it was over a long time ago.
Call it no gain on the keeper, and it's going to bring up a fourth down.
You know what? I know it's fourth down, and they've got a big lead, but go for it.
Yeah, and why not, right? Because they have the big lead. But don't you have to have a little bit of admiration for these guys on the defensive side of the ball? They've been shoved around this entire game, and they're making a nice goal line stand here. It would be fun to see them stop them on fourth down, wouldn't it?
Yeah, but it's like putting whipped cream on broccoli at this point.
So what you're saying is they're going to go for it on fourth down. They're going to get it, aren't they?
I would. Well, ultimately, not really sure that they're going to need those 3 points, but they'll take the 3 and they pad that lead.
Yeah, this one's already wrapped up, but you and I both know, if you're an offensive coordinator, you never let up on the gas unless the head coach tells you to do so. And maybe you've actually clicked him off in your headset so that you can keep calling plays and trying to add to this lead.
The punter Pinion now to kick this one away.
And he takes this near the 25, just a little pass there, call it the 26.
The Panthers offense here, they get ready to head back on the field.
Well, I hate to say it, but at this point, I don't really know that they're playing to win with this deficit in the fourth quarter. They're just trying to erase that 0 on the scoreboard, Charles, and get some type of momentum to carry into the film session tomorrow.
If you get any type of points on the board, it'll count as a moral victory, although no one will talk about that in the post-game press conference. That's not something you mention in the NFL. And this loss, it already stings and will for a while, but everyone on that offense knows it'll sting a lot worse if they don't put some points up on the board.
And they're able to get this one across the 35. Nice way to start the drive, a gain of 12 and a first down. Offense for them has been at a premium. You wonder where plays like that have been all game long.
They're thinking the exact same thing themselves, but they're also looking forward now, because now these plays are really for next week, trying to get some momentum going.
Out of the gun, it's Dalton.
Got a man, that's Leggett.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down.
Now, this is certainly one of the bigger losses that we are going to see for quite some time, and you have to think at this point where we're at in the fourth quarter with how wide this advantage is. For this offense, they're just trying to end things with a positive drive and then get the heck out of here.
Yeah, if this had been a concert, you would have heard plenty of sour notes in this one. But they certainly don't want to end it on one. They want to put together a few more throws like that and at least have a final drive to give them a little bit more hope as they move forward.
Yeah, that's good for a gain of 6, and it'll be second down. And again, Andy Dalton to throw.
They'll set up the screen here for Hubbard.
And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
Well, they certainly had success throughout this contest getting him the ball in the passing game, and there he picks up another first down. Whatever they saw going into this one, they've been able to capitalize on it, and no adjustment has been made to take it away.
Throwing, Dalton. He's going to be sacked. They sack him back right at the midfield stripe.
And that's Grady Jarrett, who forced his way through to register the sack. I don't know what else can be said about this pass rush. They have been sensational. CD, that is now 6 sacks for them.
And how many times do we talk to offensive coordinators and they say a sack is a result of everyone on offense not doing their job? But let's be honest about this one. This is the offensive line unable to counter the pass rush. They've been teeing off all game long.
That huge loss on the sack makes this job much more difficult. It's now second down and 22 yards to go. Under pressure, they got him again. Matt Judon picks up his 2nd sack of the afternoon.
This offensive line flat out cannot handle this pass rush. We've seen it demonstrated time and time again to the tune of 7 sacks in this game thus far.
Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. Dalton here from the gun. And he's going to go down again. Grady Jarrett. The offensive line is in tatters as that's now 3 sacks and 3 plays.
Well, this has turned into an absolute week to forget for this quarterback. Multiple sacks, pair that with multiple turnovers. As far as he's concerned, if he ever sees this defense again, it'll be way too soon.
So time runs out. It's a victory for the Atlanta Falcons. And I tell you what, Charles, this might be about as good as it gets. They were incredible.
Yeah, offense was in fine form. The defense threw the shutout at them. I think they worked in concert together. What I like about the offense was they held the ball pretty well. You know, time of possession, exactly what they were looking for in this one. And that helped out their defense. Didn't have to be out there the entire time. So when you do that and you're out there fresh playing, off a little extra spring in your step, and it showed up in this one.
They had a ton of spring in their step. Impressive victory.
So that'll do it for us. For my partner, Charles Davis, and all the hard-working men and women on our crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL right here on EA Sports. Till next time, we say so long from Charlotte.